Okay, so we'll start with four dots. Okay, so this will be a kind of border for me. So I just want to create a simple step out. Okay, I want to show you about one way or the two way. So it starts with an orb, okay, and then so this is the first way of creating the tangle, and then thereafter I just create a line. Then I turn my tile because this is my most comfortable position, and I take the stroke from the bottom towards me and touch the stem. Once again, I start from the bottom towards me and I touch this line. Every time it is the same motion of lines. So this tangle looks very interesting on a zendala border or any kind of borders. And now I'm going to start the tangle from here and bring it to the base. So this was the original step out of the tangle knot. Okay. This is the first way. And the second way we're gonna create is today. Okay, so you can use any of the way you like. So sorry for all the shaky video. Try my best to keep it straight now. Right? Then just try to create a wavy line. I'm going to bring it as much down as possible. So you can imagine a large flower shape or maybe an omelette. So just think in any way you want. So I'll just keep creating auras and bring those lines above here. So this is more like an organic shape. Create clusters of tangle knot, or you can just create one or two. Right, so you can bring all the auras till this point, or you can go up till the top, so it doesn't matter. And then I'm going to overlap here. Same thing, but this time I'm bringing the lines from the top to bottom. So it's very interesting and fun tangle. It's like a nicely little egg or a mother's womb wrapped up fully. It's a very nice, cozy jungle. So now I'll just try to add anything that interests me. Sometimes a simple petal shape, just a few, interests me a lot. You can create Zen gems as well, or anything in colors. I'm actually presently remotely working. I'm at my mom's home. I'm just trying to find the right space to art and tangle. I think I should have set up the whole thing on the ground instead of this soft bed. Is making the whole video and table shake, but we're gonna work with whatever we have, right? I'm going to fuss about what we have. So I'm gonna create aura. Just some line. You can create anything that interests you. Just relax. As I tangle, I just forget the space I mean. Then I'm gonna create small little moons here. And then just create a line of aura. Maybe I'll create on every another one. Over here, maybe I can create some lines. So it looks like a turban. Interesting little turbans we have. So now I plan to create a tangle called Hako. Okay, and I'm gonna create just few pencil grid lines. Right. and then I'm gonna start creating a nice square or diamond like shape, big ones, and each of this square shape will touch the other one. So it's okay if your lines are not symmetrical, because tangle hacko is a very fun pattern. Right, so now the same thing I do here. Just go about with the same fun. And then this is the last full one. I'm gonna imagine as though the tangle is falling out. Now I'm gonna add auras. Okay. So now I'm going to create a line that is passing, and that has to be slightly larger. Okay, so it won't be exactly meeting, it has to go a bit down. I think that too we'll be covering it very soon. Generally, the tangle pattern looks very beautiful as a border tangle as well. But since we are creating it in a grid, I'm going to play accordingly. I think this looks good. Yeah. Perfect. So now just the leg shape over here. So you can see that I'm turning my tile as I go. Just eyeball this and create that V-like shape, which is quite right angle. So take care that you create a right angle shape. If you guys are following me since quite time, I have a lot of liking for grid patterns. So as much as I love organic tangles, I don't know, I'm a bit partial to all the great candles as well. Mathematically, I'm really not so good, I tell you that. It's very hard for me to count numbers, and I often commit some mistake or the other. But I don't know why, I enjoy taking a little bit of small breaks and create these kind of grid patterns. I need to go to Sigmund Freud to understand what is exactly happening underneath me. So here I'm gonna create an X, so that automatically creates this shape. Don't have to really think where I'm going, what I'm doing, right? Now I'm gonna aura repetitively. And I'm going to create this dot . So this is fun, isn't it? So let's just create some interesting panes here. We have this window panes. The lines, we can just have this fun. If you feel, you can even color it or maybe just blacken it. So I want to create just one sided. I'm going to add slight a bit of graphite and then shade the part that has the crescent moon. Can add slight bit, don't want more. Like to shade just one side of this ribbon. now with my tortillon. I'm sorry, I'm using the most dirtiest tortillon. I haven't settled here and I'm just using whatever I have. And it works like a charm. It's more than this. Now I'll add shading. On the outside of these diamond panes. Then whatever graphite is left, you can just use it to create on the borders if you want. If you want, you can create some embellishments over here. Just to increase the beauty. I think I'm gonna add some dots and lines just to give it look a flowery shape. Here's tangle, hacko and knot. I'm going to write it behind tangle's knot and hacko. Today's date. July 15th, 2021. Thank you.